Utah.
It is a very sad week in Chicago because of the loss in a automobile accident near Toronto on Monday of Keith Magnuson. I know you played against him. Your recollections?
Well, the thing I remember about Keith, he came out of college, and for every Canadian or American hockey player playing college in the late 60s and early 70s, we were pulling for this guy, Doc, because the reputation was college players couldn't play in the NHL because they weren't tough enough. And Keith Magnuson came in his first game. He was tough. He played with a big heart. And everybody from that era was pulling for him because we thought, well, you know what? If he can make it, maybe this attitude about college players will change. And it sure did. And he was one of the greatest Hawks ever.
Well, there's going to be a ceremony before the game, and we want to take you there to it. 24-year veteran announcer of the Blackhawks, Pat Foley, will MC a very tragic night here in Chicago and a very tragic week. He'll be introduced by the public address announcer here at United Center, Gene Honda.
Ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to center ice as we join Pat Foley in a tribute to a Blackhawk legend who recently passed away, Keith Magnuson. Pat?
He came to us after starting on the Saskatchewan Prairies, went to the Mile High City to win an NCAA championship, and when this University of Denver Dynamo arrived in Chicago, he helped the Blackhawks go from worst to first. His play with the Blackhawks showed his heart. Then he proceeded to steal our hearts. On the ice, he was a reflection of the city of Chicago. Big shoulders, blue collar, hard-nosed, passionate, loyal. He wore number 3 with pride and brought honor to everyone who has ever worn the Indian Head jersey. Even after his playing days ended, he never stopped battling to make things better. He supported countless charities throughout North America, tirelessly giving of his time. He helped form the Chicago Blackhawk Alumni Association that has become the envy of all professional sports teams. In the past 16 years, the alumni have helped 54 young people go to college. The intensity that marked his playing career has impacted the lives of thousands. Keith Magnuson stood up for what was right on the ice, and he lived the way he played. He was everything a Chicago Blackhawk should be, and he was everything you would want your son to grow up to be. Now let's look back on the life of the Atomic Redhead, the greatest captain the Blackhawks have ever had, Keith Magnuson.
You know, the fans would like to know a little more about Keith Magnuson, where you were born and when you started playing hockey.
I was born in Saskatoon, Saskatchewan, Canada, Harvey, the same place where Gordie Howe was born. And I started playing hockey when I was 4 years old. I moved up through the minor ranks, went through college, and then into professional hockey.
I just feel that in whatever you do, and I know you believe this too, you got to give 100%, and I think that's what life's all about. Why go through and do something mediocre when you can do it really well? And I'm not saying I do it well, but I try hard anyway.
I was never gifted with great speed. I was pretty big for that day and age. And I played with spirit and pride more than with talent. Cherish every second and every moment of the the fact that you're on a professional hockey team like Chicago Blackhawks. Cherish it because it goes by so quickly, and all of a sudden you think, where were those 11 years? Savor the moment, because too soon, too quickly it goes by.
A marvelous human being, a great hockey warrior, both the Devils and the Blackhawks on the ice for this observance for Keith Magnuson. The opening faceoff in just a moment.